Hello. We are doing a recording right now. Wham, bam, thank you, ma'am, on Ashton Kutcher. I don't really know what's going on with him, other than probably what the world knows about the Danny Masterson writing a letter in defense of this, like, rapist. And I got puppet master vibes when I watched him and Mila doing this together. I just didn't like the vibe I got. And I just saw he, like, stepped down from the board of, like, the sex trafficking, protecting children, which is, I'm going to ask the cards and not put my own energy into it. We've already called in the quarters and asked for the highest and whitest light, archangels, and spirit guides, spirit teams for Ashton, my best friend, and I, and anyone else who's watching this. So, Ashton Kutcher, what's going on? Alright, these cards are hot. Underlying energy. Oh man, Three of Swords. Okay, oh boy. Oh man, this kid's a train wreck. Alright. Okay. Alright. Well, we don't have. Alright, so Ash. And yes, well, I don't know if, oh, Two of Swords. All right, so right off the rip, we have the Three of Swords. Threes are union, can be division. Three's a party, three's a crowd, or Father, Son, and Holy Ghost, like the perfect trinity. This is in reverse, so it's a broken heart with three swords stabbed through it, but it's in reverse, so maybe he was betrayed. Maybe he had some parent issues. But he's a train wreck. I don't know. I feel like he doesn't even have his personality. Okay, cards, I know you hate it when you do this. I'm going to clear this energy. And I'm going to do this again. We're just going to reshuffle with a different deck. Because we've got kids to coach. And we've got to get to the bottom of Ashton. So, Ashton Kutcher, what is going on with you? What do we need to know about you, Ashton Kutcher? Where are you hiding? Actually, I'm going to do Mila. Actually, I might do Ashton on the left, Mila on the right, and see what the energy is between them. There's something way off, and I don't know if it's him or if it's their energy. But that video was not convincing that everything was okay in the hood the other day. I thought it was sketchy. So, this is right on the heels of Danny Masterson convicted of, like, multiple essays in federal court and Scientology, yada yada. So we're going to do a quick Ashton. We might do Mila if she comes up. I don't feel her energy as, like, as dark. But we'll just see where it takes us. Oh, these cards are ready. All right, AC. Underlying, oh, well, the tower. All right, so your life's a complete mess. Okay. All right, these two cards jumped out, the Empress and the Fool. Huh, so your world's coming down around you. Hi, Ashton, thank you so much for coming to get a reading. I know, I'm curious too. Your world is collapsing before your eyes. The tower, some people like to write it off and say it's like winning the lottery. No, 9/11 and towers falling was not winning a lottery. It's a life-changing, catastrophic event, in my opinion. Then we have the King of Wands. So this guy, he's like a natural leader. He's always looking. Well, he's a king, so we have to respect that. He's career-focused, mature. He is also, well, wands are fire, so he starts the spark. He can be fighting too. Then we had the Fool in reverse. This is like, the Fool is someone who, it's, you know, we all get to go on a fool's journey every time we come down here and multiple times through our lives. When it's in reverse, it's like not listening to advice, not looking in front of you and taking a critical thought. Like, you're not thinking anything on your own. Everything is done for you because maybe you grew up with money, I have no idea, but he didn't have to make any critical thinking skills. And then we have the Empress in reverse. This could be, maybe as mommy and daddy issues. The Empress in reverse is like, I would call her a train wreck. She's like selfish. The Empress upright is like any kind of abundance, mature. It's like a grandma, kind of, that's an older vibe. It's like a very strong female. In reverse, it's just like, this is your cheating card. This is anxiety. Oh, okay. If someone could check, I bet you his parents cheated on it. There was a divorce that was heartbreaking. He might be the oldest son or maybe the only son of these two, but it was a complete train wreck. Then we have Two of Pentacles in reverse. So Two of Pentacles upright would be like duality, seeing the dark in the night or the dark in the light. You know, you have night and day. Your world is falling around. Like, whatever smoke and mirrors, like, clown show you were running is over. Your game is up. Time's up. And you know it. In reverse, okay, so we have the Two of Pentacles. It's like disorganized, overcommitted, doesn't remember, basically could be a liar. I'm not saying you did lie, but people might have done it for you. If you grew up loaded, you were very well taken care of in the sense of money, emotions, and like you didn't really have to grow up. Okay, that's fine because it's not working out for you now, but oh, Scientology. Oh, you were a Scientologist. Okay, hold on, because then we got the Five in reverse. This is like spiritually bankrupt, recover from financial loss. If you haven't lost everything yet, you are about to. And I think you, oh man, if we get the Hierophant, oh man, dude, the Ace of Cups in reverse. Okay, I'm going to just call this the Nine of Pentacles. I'm just gonna flip a few more. If we get, well, the Lovers in reverse, yeah, we know you're a train wreck, Two of Swords. I feel like the Hierophant is just about to jump out at us. The Hierophant is you gave all of your money over to this, like, woo-woo, and I'm into woo-woo. What I'm not into is, like, paying for it in the sense of Scientology. So you gave all of your money, they wrote your press releases, oh, they were your PR team. Oh, you, okay, so you, like, I bet you, Paige, where's our Paige? You were, like, young teen when you, maybe your mom got you involved, someone got you involved, and they ran all your PR for you, you sold them all your secrets, and they had you by the balls. Well, you stopped playing this game, but not by your own accord. I think that maybe Danny or whatever's going on behind the scenes outed you. There's like a code word for you. Oh my goodness. I'm not really liking what I'm seeing. And maybe the boards that you're sitting on, maybe they weren't so pure. Yuck. The Ace of Cups is like in reverse, first of all, is like emotional loss, blocked creativity, emptiness, repressed emotions. Well, the next card I would expect to see pretty soon is the Hierophant and the Devil. Then we have the Two of Swords in reverse. You have no choice. Your hands are tied. You made a deal with the devil, and now he's coming to, you know, what is it? Like, you reap what you sow. You planted these seeds, and now it's time for your harvest, which is looking like you might get suicided or jailed, and I'm not even saying that funny. I mean that really seriously, because then we have the Six of Cups in reverse. That means, like, empty cups. You are emotionally, mentally, physically, everything bankrupt, nothing. If this was a health reading, you don't even have enough of one thing. You're just a train wreck. This is what I'm guessing, is that maybe you trusted these people at one time. You signed away your autonomy or something to them. They could create this star, Ashton Kutcher. It's not who you really are. You don't know who you really are because you didn't get the chance to grow into it. But they have you by the balls and they are about to collect. So then we have the Lovers in reverse. That goes without saying. That's the opposite of the Devil. So that's like disharmony, yin and yang. Nothing is adding up. The duality, Lovers in reverse is like also a breakup. This could be hinting on your parents. Ooh, boy, there's lots of fighting at home. Who are you fighting with? Like, if these guys in Scientology, maybe Mila is getting, Mila, I don't know. I like her for the 10 seconds I've seen her, which was this week, but maybe she got whitewashed with you. Like, I don't know if she has her own personality, but because I'm not getting any strong females here, I'm getting a lot of male energy. And this is almost like the Alex Murdaugh case. It's like years and years and years of debauchery. And, okay. Years and years and years of debauchery. Oh, well. Oh. Okay. So I'm going to ask you. All right. Yes. These cards are leading up to it. And I have 5 minutes. I'm going to clear these cards. Your life is in the shithole, okay? Good luck with that. No, I'm just kidding. Years and years and years of horrible decisions brought you to that. But I'm going to ask about Ashley.
Ask about Ashley.
Yeah, I was just about to say I'm going to ask about Ashley. And my mom's texting me to see if I need a ride. We have 5 minutes, team. Ashley. Oh, let's just... You know what I want to use for Ashley? I don't want to use dark cards for her because I feel like she's light. Okay, Ashley, can you kind of shed some light on what happened to you and why Ashton was at your house, coincidentally, who placed him there? Was that like a poker hand he lost? He made like a deal with the devil and he lost it, and so his team, the Scientology, whoever his PR team is, placed in there. No one actually saw him. He came forward and said it was him, which could also be like questionable. We'll go into that. But Ashley, are you around? Would you like to talk to us, Ashley? Tell us what happened. Ashley, whoa. All right, she's definitely ready to talk. All right, these cards jumped out, so I'm going to set them aside. And, oh man, dude. Okay, King of Cups. All right, Ashley. My mom's leaving. Okay, so right off the rip, we asked about Ashley. The only thing I know about Ashley, and I don't want to give too many, like, you guys can Google it, I just can't right now. So she was a girl who was found dead in her apartment. It sounds sus, hence the name of the channel. It's like, sounds super suspicious. Right off the rip, we got the Three of Hearts, and that's like a heartbreak card. I don't know if he's a heartbreaker or he just is a perpetual victim. Ooh, whoa. If they said this was a drug overdose, they're lying. They did. Okay, so for Miss Ashley. Hi, Ashley. Thank you so much for coming through. I appreciate this. Such short notice. We'll come back, I promise. Yes, we are going to give Ashley her time to shine. She has a story she'd like to tell, and I'm really sorry. I never do this, but... I have to go coach. So I want to get this out and then we'll revisit this tonight. Ashley, okay, so I'm guessing, you know what? Okay, yes, they did. This was not a falling down a set of stairs. Swords. So swords are throat. Did they give you a drink that had... like a roofied, but it was like way too much roofie. If you were roofied, oh, it could be a needle. Oh, okay, because we have swords. I mean, right off the rip, swords are gonna be like your throat chakra, your respiratory system. This is like speaking. I hope they didn't, okay, I think there's a combination of things, and yes, I promise I will come back to you, and I will do this and give you the moments, yes, that you need. So, for Miss Ashley, God, we rest her soul, rest in peace, we love you. We have the Hangman in reverse. So, I think you walked into this completely blindsided. You had no idea that you were like a pawn in a bigger game. Like, there was a bigger fish. I think they set Ashton up, actually, to be honest. I don't know if he was there either. I'm not getting him at all. Ooh, this is not good, Missy. I'm so sorry. Okay, so, and I do remember reading that they, like, left, he allegedly, I don't believe any of that, but he allegedly saw you through a window on the floor and of like a living room floor or something. And right here we have the Four of Swords. That's like, some people call it your rest and relaxation. Well, first of all, if I'm resting and relaxing, I don't have a coffin to sleep on, and I don't have a sword in my forehead, my throat, and my stomach on top of a sword. No, there's no resting. This person is dead. Sorry. Love you. Thank you. Next one we have is Ace of Swords. So this is like conflict surgery. Oh my God. Were you missing a kidney? Is this one of those sketchy ass things? Okay, we need to do some research on this. I'll have my faves look it up for me. But make sure if they did a full autopsy that all of her kidneys were there, or whatever organs people like to harvest, because, okay, first of all, this was a full-blown murder. I think it was roofied and then shot up with like a hot shot or whatever that is. Then they cut out. There was some, maybe they called it a beating. I don't believe it. I believe that they beat her after. Maybe they beat her while she was alive, but their goal was to get these organs. And I have no idea, but I did see something about Selena Gomez's kidney is super sus. We can look into that. That I know the answer to, and it's not her friend. Okay, the next one that we have is the Ten of Swords. You were set up. So this is like backstabbing. And it's not in reverse. It's not like these swords are falling out and you're healing. No, you were stabbed in the back. You didn't see it coming. I don't think you were beaten alive. Like, if they beat you, you weren't still alive. Because I remember Ashton Kutcher saying there was a lot of blood. But if they took some of your organs, there would be a lot of blood too. I bet you the autopsy is inconclusive or some bullshit like that. Oops, sorry. And then the last one that we have is the Seven of Cups in reverse. So everything's gone. They lost everything. They had to, this is gross. Like, I think they had plans for you that did not include you dying, but you might have fought back. I'm not seeing that you even had the chance. Honestly, this was almost like a covert, oh gosh, we'll call it the Russians. You know, the Kremlin back in the 80s used to do some covert shit, like sneak into someone's house and like give them a shot and they don't even know what happened. There was no fighting here. You had no chance to fight back. If they said you did, they're lying. And there was no self-defense wounds.
Hi, you have reached Kristen Shea.
That was so weird.
Dude, someone from LA just called me.
Wait, what?
Yeah, I thought it was you, so I switched over. It's, I don't know. It's LA. I'll call him back.
Please leave your message
after. Oh. Oh, dude. Did you just hear that?
No, what was it?
It was one of those it's not a robocall. It's like someone's cell phone that's set up to please leave a message after the tone. Oh boy, what am I hitting on that's like not good, but
dude, I don't know, but the fact that it ended the call, then I tried to call you, it went right to voicemail, wouldn't even go through, and then you called, and that's that. I do feel like we tapped into something we're not supposed to.
Okay, well, we named a bunch of shit. We named organ harvesting, sex trafficking, CIA, and celebrities are covering it, and they used Ashton Kutcher. Ashton owed them something, and he became the scapegoat because he couldn't say anything. Yeah, this is good. We're good. We got what we needed. Ashley, thank you. RIP. I love you. Goodbye. Yeah. Thank you for coming.
So crazy.